Teenage Genesis, of course, is in the books and one of my thoughts, but I will be doing that, of course, in my review. Until then, you know what's coming up next, and that's right, roll my intro. Alright, so I want to thank each and every one of you guys for coming in into the pay-per-view pre-show for Genesis. For those of you who are able to make it, I thank you. And I do apologize, of course, we did have some technical difficulties going into the show. So usually I'm the one with the difficulties, but things returned with that, so I do apologize. And of course, we still try to make the show still as enjoyable, even though with the difficulties that we did have. But for those of you who are able to stick around and join us with the show, I thank you guys for sticking by us. And of course, I'm sure by the Rumble, the show will be back better than ever. So hopefully this is a one-time thing, but anyway, it was still a great show nonetheless. Alright, so we kick things off with the first match of the night. Of course, we had the X Division Championship, which was on the line, and this one was a Fatal 4-Way. Now, with this one, it was treated as an elimination-style match, which I wasn't really a fan of. And with this one, we had Jesse Sorensen, Zema Ion, Kid Cash, and as well the champion, Austin Aries. And this one was a good first match to kick things off for Genesis, of course. So I was into this one. It was a good, fast-paced match, and I would have preferred it to be just a straight Fatal 4-Way for really to have every man for himself, but, you know, it really didn't go down that way. And with this one, we did get to see Kid Cash, I believe, was the first one to get eliminated, and early, I believe. And then after that, we did get to see some of the other guys get eliminated. And towards the end, we almost did get to see Jesse Sorensen to get the win, which I was hoping that wouldn't happen. And of course, in the end, that's right, Austin Aries was able to come back and, that's right, retain his X Division Championship. So I thought that was a good win for Austin Aries and a good way to kick things off, of course, for Genesis. Now, with the next match, I didn't really care for, of course, we had Devon and the Pope. And to me, honestly, I think both of them deserve at least something better than having this feud, which I really don't care about. It's gotten really confusing. And hopefully, this feud, hopefully, has come to an end at Genesis. And with this one, of course, we did get to see Devon actually coming out on top, which I would have preferred the Pope to get the win. But hey, it is what it is, and it was an okay match, so wasn't really that much into it. So hopefully this feud comes in and we see maybe Pope and Devon go on and do better things from this and have this finally end at Genesis. Alright, so we move along into the next match, and with this one was actually a good match, and I was somewhat into this one. Now, to me, I will admit Gunnar has been doing a good job as a heel as of late and really taking guys out like Jesse Neal and as well Eric Bischoff's son and a couple of other guys, and really it was no different going into Genesis and Gunnar looking to really continue his streak going, if you will, and taking guys out and looking to move on to better things. And with this one, it was a good match, and RVD did his best trying to get back in this one and take out Gunnar himself, but in the end, of course, Gunnar does get the defeat over RVD, and really, we did get to see that DDT that Gunnar has been using onto the floor, really, and taking out RVD there. So you gotta wonder what's gonna happen next with RVD next. You know, there's been rumors saying that he might go to WWE. I'm not really too sure about that, but, you know, probably RVD will probably come back and continue this feud. We'll have to wait and see what's going to happen next. But anyway, it was a good match for what it was worth. Then we move along into, yes, of course, the Knockouts Championship match, the match I was looking forward for. And with this one, I liked when Velvet Sky did come back in this one, looking to be having a position for being the next Knockout VP and really having a twist going into this one and trying to take and have, that's right, Madison Rayne to be out of this match, since we've been seeing that week after week in a way, and as well going into this feud. So it was nice to see at least to try to have Madison get out of this and really get in the cage, which I enjoyed. So however, I didn't like the point where they had to have Madison Rayne still unfortunately help Gail Kim get the win there. We see the brass knucks and really Mickey James, to me at least, looking to be frustrated after having Madison Rayne get involved once again. And you know, people seem to think that Mickey James is going to be heel. I don't really see it that way. To me, in a fan's point of view, I do see Mickey James just really being frustrated, and we might have that street fight or whatever, some sort of maybe stipulation going into the next pay-per-view following Genesis. So something really has to give there, and I was hoping for Mickey James to get the win and bring the Knockouts Championship back home, but unfortunately, it didn't really happen, and I was hoping for a mark-out moment, but that didn't happen either. In the end, it was still a good match, and I still enjoyed it, but hopefully Madison Rayne will not get involved next time, and that's right, she will get her ass handed to her, guarantee. But anyway, it was a good match, and I still enjoyed it nonetheless. Now, this next match, of course, did surprise me, and I thought it was a good match, with the Monsters Ball match between Abyss and as well Bully Ray. Now going into this one, I was going for Bully Ray and to have Abyss turn heel and rejoin Immortal and be more dominant as a heel, but really things did turn around for me, and I was actually surprised on what happened with this one. And this match was a brutal match, and we see a lot of weapons used in this one. We see the return of Janus, we see the thumbtacks, really cool spots in this one, and both of these guys really looking to try and take each other out, and really just a bloody war between Abyss and Bully Ray. So in the end, who ends up getting the win? And that's right, Abyss with the Black Hole Slam right onto the barbed wires, which is actually pretty sick there. So really just a brutal match, and I thought it was a good match there. And even though Bully Ray didn't get the win, it was actually pretty cool seeing Abyss get the win there. So nonetheless, it was a good match, and I was into that one as well. Then we move along into the Tag Team Championship matchup between Crimson and Matt Morgan. And as well with this one, we had Samoa Joe and Magnus. And this didn't really care for it too much, you know, I wasn't that much into this match. And of course, it was pretty obvious, that's right, Matt Morgan and Crimson were able to get the win there. Even though it would have been nice to see Samoa Joe get the win and have a championship, but of course Samoa Joe was not able to get the win here. So even though he tried with the help of Magnus and everything, so we did see some pretty cool stuff in this one as well. We see the double teams and all that stuff, but in the end, Crimson and as well Matt Morgan both retaining the tag team championships, and that was pretty good for what it was worth there. Alright, so next we move along into Kurt Angle against James Storm, and this one I was looking forward for this one, and with my pick I was going with James Storm. Even though if Kurt Angle was able to get a win here, it really wouldn't have mattered, and it was a win-win situation for me since I like both guys going into this one. So this feud has been actually good, and with the match in itself, I thought it was a good match, and we really had basically a technical match between the two. We see the triple vertical German suplexes by Kurt Angle. We see Kurt Angle looking to go on the top rope and do the moonsault. Of course, James Storm looking to come back on top and really end things with this feud. And in the end, who ends up getting the win? And that's why Kurt Angle does defeat James Storm in this one. So that really too pissed off about, you know, who won this one. So it was a good match, and I'm not too sure if this feud is going to continue. If Kurt Angle is going to look to be a world champion again, I don't know. Or we might see this feud continue, and we'll probably have a rematch or something like that going into the next pay-per-view after Genesis. So anyway, it was a good match, and that's basically it when it comes to my thoughts. Alright, so we move along into the main event. That's right, Jeff Hardy against Bobby Roode, and this one was for the TNA World Heavyweight Championship. Now with this one, looking to have Jeff Hardy put 2011 behind him, especially with the crazy shit that went down with him and his personal demons and all that stuff. So looking to try and gain respect from the fans and as well for everyone in the locker room and in the company in general. So with this one, it was a pretty good match. You know, I didn't really get to see some of it since my stream basically fucked up there. But in the end, who ends up getting the win? And that's why Bobby Roode ends up retaining the World Heavyweight Championship, which was my pick, by the way, for this match. So it was a pretty good match. You know, wasn't really too much into it, but at least Bobby Roode was able to get the retain, since I didn't really see Jeff Hardy getting the win here. Maybe at the next pay-per-view or the one following that, and just really having to test to see if Jeff Hardy can earn that trust again and eventually become World Heavyweight Champion. And of course, I am a fan of Jeff Hardy, so with this one, I didn't think it was his time just yet, but it was nice to see Bobby Roode get the win there and retain the World Heavyweight Championship. So yeah, that about does it for me for TNA Genesis 2012. Of course, let me know what you guys' thoughts are on the pay-per-view in itself, what you liked, what you didn't like about it. Be sure to leave a like on this video, and as well be sure to leave your thoughts down below in the comment box, and as well feel free to leave a video sponsor or all three. That is perfectly fine with me, and I want to thank you guys for coming in, as well for those of you who are able to make it to the pay-per-view pre-show. And of course, I do apologize with the technical difficulties that we had, even though we still made it for a great show nonetheless, besides the technical difficulties. And of course, also for tomorrow night on Raw, that's right, we will be having the final Raw post show. We might bring it back, I'm not too sure. That's all up to S&D and what he's going to do with that. And hopefully you guys can be a part of that as well. And that's about it for the rest of the review and for this video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it, and as well the brand new intro. And thanks for going to S&D, courtesy of that brand new intro. So anyway, that's it for me. Until then, peace.